Justin Gorham here from Manchester Public TV. We have our next game up is Goffstown High School and Hollis Brookline, and we saw them play the other day, not each other, but they did play last time. Our previous game was an upset victory. Bo came from behind to win by two against Nashua North, so that was a lot of fun. This game features probably the best player in the entire summer league. So last name Walsh, I'm going to work on the first name, I can't remember right now, but she's the best player in the summer league by far. So we'll see if we can have some fun, maybe have a good game, and we'll have less jump balls. So hopefully you enjoy the game, and we'll be back in just a minute. All right, here we go, folks. Jump ball, Goffstown in red, Hollis Brookline in white. Goffstown kind of just tips the ball, but does not win the tip. Tips a little too hard from behind, and that means the Hollis Brookline Cavaliers will get the ball first. And in one of our many jump balls, the Grizzlies of Goffstown will get the ball next. So we had nine jump balls last game. We're going to go, there's that up fake dribble. We're going to go with the glaring stat. Our first game, I think we had about 16 jump balls. Last game we had nine. Traveling violation. And we're going to see how many jump balls we have in this game. And then we'll come up with an average number of jump balls in the Varsity Girls Basketball Summer League. And Walsh is number 22, so keep your eye on her. She likes to go left. Almost every time she drives to the basket, she goes left. So I would, you know, if you're a player or a coach, you got to recognize that. She's right-handed, but she really likes going left. Went left on that pass. She's got a player and make her go right if you're playing defense. Push out of bounds. Nice steal, got a finish. There's the foul, hard foul. Not a bad foul, you just gotta be careful so you don't get the intentional foul call, which would be two shots and the ball out of bounds. So good foul, she didn't make the lay-in. And you gotta make those shots. It's a good foul when you don't make the free throws, especially. That offhand. She goes to her left, sticks the right hand out, pushes off a little bit. No call. She had her backed in underneath the basket. You got to go up. I don't think I remember ever seeing a young girl when I was in high school. Nice three-pointer. There she is, Walsh. Off the bat. It's a three. 3-1. Goffstown. I don't remember seeing, I think, one girl this young in high school with a torn ACL. Happened very rarely. I mean, I know they took play, they occurred, but maybe they weren't seeing them or finding them as much, or, you know, a girl hurts her knee and they don't really worry about it, but I've seen so many knee braces out here. Nice drive. 3-3. So many knee braces that indicate a torn ACL. We got a big one on number 22, huge brace, which means probably tore that ACL. It's a rather glaring kind of up fake dribble kick. Basketball has become so predictable. Up fake dribble kick. Bad pass, bounce pass. See, all predictability. Chance in the passing lane, you're going to get a steal. basket left-hand. You got to make her go right. All right, so here's what you do. She's not left-handed. And typically you can tell when somebody is left-handed and you force them right, because that's usually not their stronger hand. I think she's stronger going to her left. Right-handed shooter, but she finishes well with her left hand going left, so you make her go right. You have to adjust. You have to see what you are presented with on offense when you're a defensive player and adjust. See, right now she's the smartest player that I've seen so far and the best player. Again, there it goes, left. Got a shot blocked, out of bounds. There's another young player, I believe, for Concord that we'll see today. And her skill level is really, really high. But I think she might only be a freshman, so pay attention. We'll get a number on her if she's here. You'll be able to tell. It does things really well. Very talented. Didn't shoot well on Tuesday night, but did a lot of other things well. You can just tell by the way she carries herself. Another three by Walsh. 7-3, Goffstown. Hollis Brookline does have an advantage inside. Body foul. Blocked it up top, but got her in the body and the head. Seven to four. Goffstown leads. That's another example of who is supposed to be shooting threes. Not everyone. Back to the corner, short on a three. It's a new play. That's the Golden State Warriors play where you pass the ball to someone quick and you just run around them. It's almost like with the ball, they kind of set a screen. You know, it's a screen, but it's not. And you get the ball right back in a shot. It works out pretty well for the Warriors. You see Steph Curry do it a lot in the corners. He has to get the ball back and shoot it quick. Once you figure it out, though, you can get there and trap and stop that. I mean, Steph Curry shot's hard to stop, but most normal players, you can stop that quick if you get there and trap. Let's see if she goes left. Yep. Starts left. Loves to lean left. Comes down the floor, left hand goes right to the left side. And that, again, atypical. Right-handed players typically go to the right side of the floor on, 75-80% of the time, whereas left-handed players will do the opposite. Makes sense, right? She's a conundrum. The right-handed player who goes to her left more than her right. There's a jump ball, folks. And my jump ball chart going. 12-17, low-scoring game. 7-4. Goffstown. Walsh misses another three. Nice shot, Hollis Brookline. 7-6, a one-point game. There's a catch and shoot, 15-footer. Nice shot. Love the catch and shoot. My favorite part of the game, catch and shoot. Frustration play. Turn the ball over and then go for the tackle. First down. to call it our stat of the day. We'll steal that from the legendary Dan Patrick Show. The stat of the day will be jump balls, jump ball total, the girls varsity basketball summer league at Memorial. Jump ball total. Nice shot. Over under is going to be set at 59.5. I'm taking the over, folks. Defense. Nice hands on the ball. Good defense. Moved her feet. And then got beat, but that's okay. Had her hand on the ball. Good position defense, but kind of gave up once she knocked the ball away. Quickness, though. That's all lateral quickness. Not quite there yet. That young lady looks like she's going to grow a little bit more. Just kind of tell. Hasn't quite grown into her body yet. Should have been another jump ball, but instead we have a wide open layup. We'll go layup this game as opposed to lay-in. Layup, good shot. .922 to go, 10-8 Goffstown. No, 10-10, I'm sorry. That left hand again, going left. She goes left, coach. So you want to go coach. If you're an assistant coach, you say coach. You make her go right. Make her go right, coach. She's right-handed. Yes, make her go right. Goes left every time. So far, she's gone to the basket about four times, and she's gone left every time. 12-10, though. Nice shot. Good finish. Shot 12-12. Rebound inside. Tough finish. Way to stay with it. Now, that time, Hollis Brookline stayed with it. .15-14, Goffstown. .6:30 to go in the first half. .15-14. Goffstown leads in red against Hollis Brookline in white. Nice steal. I'm sure they call a foul on that one. Instead of just kind of following the ball, they kind of lean over and put their hand on top of the arm. And it usually looks like a foul. Thank you. sweeping left-hand hook in the middle, no good. Hold the ball out there where they can knock it away. Great bounce pass. Oh, almost. Just a little bit behind. It's a great look, though. Smart play. Wide open in the corner. Just can't get it to fall. Smart play, though. See how she guided and pointed to where people are supposed to go? And they didn't know she was behind. So she pointed one way, had a girl run the other side, wide open. Love that play. Very smart play. So I told you, she's the best player in this league. Very hot in here today. Not as hot as it was the other day, but all this sweatiness is starting to get to me. Yeah, right now Hollis Brookline was trying to go with six. Distinct advantage, if you will, but tricky if you can play it off. Good drive to the basket, right up the middle. 17-14. You got to watch your feet. Make sure your feet are behind the line. Tie ball game, 17-17. That makes you nuts when you're so close to the line and you give up a point. Don't reach. Good defense. Good cut. Tough pass. Try and teach that. You can't pick up your dribble. So that means you can't just catch it and just start dribbling for no reason. Cavaliers lead. Shot. 19-18, Goffstown, back and forth. Hopefully at halftime we get a foul count. Maybe get the scorekeepers to pay attention. Put some fouls on the board. Right now we have a 0-0 foul thing. I don't think that's the case. Difficult shot. Good defense. Hands straight up. Good no call. So I apologize if the voice starts to go a little bit. This is game three. Nice. Another three. Speaking of three, there's Walsh again. 22-18. Looking high arching jump shot. High arcing, more so, I guess, the arching, traveling play. Shovel the feet. God, shovel the feet. Name that group. God, shovel his feet. Late 80s, steal. That's why you don't hold the ball above your head. You don't hold it above your head. Number one, everybody knows what you're going to do. You're going to pass it. Good cut. A nice shot. 22-20. 20 seconds to go in the half. He didn't see that. That's why he called a foul on the ground. Timeout red. So he's going to try and get the last shot. Leading by two. We'll take a break and we'll be right back. 15.3 to go. Goffstown should get the last shot. See if they run anything special. 2-3 zone. Hollis Brookline. A lot of reaching. Get fouled now. Probably they're not in the 1-1. So, oh, and they don't. They turn the ball over. Get the shot off. Hey, basket's good. Nice finish. 22-20 at halftime on a turnover. Costly for the Grizzlies. So we'll take a break at halftime. And the answer to the question, the song, Crash Test Dummies. We'll be back. 22. Oh, we're on, folks. Sorry, a little discussion. Nice follow. 24-22. So we had a halftime 22-22 game. Shoot. A little short. It's a good defense by Goffstown. Played game, a very aggressive game. Not quite as many fouls in this one as the last one. So I'm not too sure how many there were because they didn't put them on the boards. That's an offensive foul. Kind of shoves the arm out there, and they didn't call that. But again, summer. Summertime. Good steal. You can't lob it. You can't lob the bounce pass. Is she going to go all the way? Thinks about it. Makes another nice bounce pass. And, ooh, almost put it in. So a good play. Good cut. Good bounce pass. Chance for two shots and two free throws and maybe build their lead to four early though in the second half, very early. Second one's good, 25-22. Foul on the play. First free throw is good. He's a good free throw shooter. And White will take a timeout. Leading by one, 25-24. We'll take a break, be right back. Pass inside. So the post The Hollis Brookline has an advantage inside the post. They're a little bit bigger, and if they keep doing that, throwing the ball inside, I think they're going to find themselves in a good position. They can score inside. Goffstown has no size to combat that. Floater, nice shot. Went left, went up in the middle. Floater is good. 27-26. Goffstown still trails by one. One foul to one. So we got them to put the fouls up on the board this time. Cut, no call. A lot of grabbing, reaching in there. No call. It's a nice shot. Oh, almost put it in. Actually, a good foul. You want to avoid the two-footer if you can. So if you're going to foul him, don't let him make the shot. Pressure in the backcourt by Hollis Brookline. Made it a little tougher to bring the ball up, but, oh, and she should have made that lightly contested layup. Just didn't finish. That's a good drive to the basket. A little short. Pass inside. 28-27, Goffstown has regained the lead. A lot of time left. A lot of game left. Finish those. You want to win the game, you got to finish those. Good foul. Hard foul, but a good foul. Two shots. Nice drive, got hit in the arm. Good play. Hollis Brookline going back and forth. This is really good defense. Staying in front, about arm's distance away. Don't get too close. Oh, double dribble, no call. There's that bump again. She goes up to shoot. You move into her lane and foul every time. Easy call. Thank you. 30-29. Goffstown again. Wide open look. Look good. Relatively close to the three-point line, not too far away. Not like the previous game where we saw NBA shooting threes. Or NBA threes. Another good drive and another foul. Nice play. She likes to go with the arm underneath, and they always foul on top. It's a really smart play. Sometimes it can bite you. They can block the shot down low. But they're swinging wildly, so smart play. It's up for the shooter, so she's going to probably miss this so she can stay in the game. No, she doesn't. 31-30. 13-36 to go in the game. Three-pointer for Walsh, 33-30. The old back in play. Now, did a good job holding the ground. Didn't move. You can't just back somebody down and knock them over. So, held the ground very well. Good smart play and defense. Good base, held her. Didn't fall down, could have fallen down, maybe gotten a charge. Or a 3-second violation on the other way. Easily in there for three with that dribble back down. You know, it's funny though, most of the time when you officiate a game, it's a 3-second call in the paint. But usually, you give them five. Another three, I think the defender might have gotten her. Got a little bit of piece of the ball, or maybe her arm. I know it hit her on the body a little bit. So it's a little short. And one more pass to the corner. Again, that catch and dribble thing. That's what we want to do, catch and dribble. There's that left-hand finish. 34-30. Hofstown now with a four-point lead. A little too high. Again, we're throwing that time. The ball was thrown to Kevin McHale, the seven-footer out of University of Minnesota, and the Boston Celtics, your team out here. Usually I go with Kareem first because I'm a Laker guy. Yeah, I know, boo me on the TV, that's fine. Just boo away. But I moved here, 15 years ago, and I've maintained my fandom. From the corner. Nice follow through. 37-30. The lead is climbing. 7-point game. That's a tough shot. You go to your left and you shoot with the right hand as you drift. A very difficult shot. 37-32. Goffstown. Strong hands. You got fouled, but you can make the shot if you use your strong hand. Free throw's good. 37-33, Goffstown. Yeah. up shot, flip shot. Hard pass. Can't catch that. Out of bounds. It'll go back to the Cavaliers of Hollis Brookline. Trailing by four. Under 10 minutes to play in the ballgame. Nice long three from the top of the key. And it makes it a one-point game, 37-36. That ball went to no one. Thought somebody was there, but nobody home. And Hollis Brookline will take a timeout, trailing by one with 8:50 to go in the game. We'll be right back. Brookline ball, 37-36. They trail by one. Back-to-back threes from about a foot behind the three-point line. Hollis Brookline now leads by two. Gotta get a hand up. Hand down. Woman down. Catch and shoot. Frozen rope three is good. 42-39. There it is, that layup again. It's a good looking shot. Should be. There we go. Don't have it quite right. Should have gone to the other side. Jump ball. Hopefully they'll get the score right. They put the points up on the wrong side. Good defense, hands straight up. Left hand and a foul. No call. Got hit in the arm. So they called that one, but not the last one on the scoop shot. She missed the second free throw, 43-41. Goffstown leads by two. I still don't think the score is right, but that's what we're rolling with right now. Nice pull up at the free throw line. A little long. Another jump ball. Foul. Oh, called red with the foul. Little push off on offense. White ball. Six fouls to five. Goffstown with six. Hollis Brookline with five. All the way to the basket. Got to go up again. Grab the rebound. Go back up. little more patience on offense. That's a good swing. Got away with the travel. Too many forced shots. Too many forced shots. Can't keep forcing shots and missing shots. If you're going to force it, you better make the shot. Catch and shoot. Two-pointer. Foot was on the line. Catch and shoot, though. 47-41. 45-41. I'm baffled. Gave it to her. Can't give it to her. Can't give it to her. Wide open. Got to put a hand up. A lot of time left. 4-point game. Goffstown leads by 4. Game's gone back and forth a couple times here in the second half. Dribbling. Had a good look, had time. Another wide open look. Tough pass, good pass. Wow, nice finish. 47-41. Did not expect to see that happen the way it did. There it is. It's about the fifth time in a row she's done that right-handed scoop shot. After making a couple threes, you got to get out. So you make her drive. Hopefully she makes the free throws. And then the game is even closer. And there's one. 47-42. Nice handoff. Left hand. I think she got hit. No call. Traveling violation. So on that one, if she would have cut her off just a little more. Charging foul. Right there, that should have been a blocking foul. But she must have traveled first. But you could tell she was going to the hoop. See how much time she bumps, how many times she bumps her. Bumped her a few times. No call. Shot in the corner. Good hustle play by Hollis Brookline. Another wide open three from the top. She has three of those today. It's a 1-point game with 2:48 to go. The Grizzlies lead by 1. Hard foul up top, obvious foul, and not a smart foul. 7 fouls to 6. Keep your eye on the ball in order to be able to catch it. And maybe that pass was too hard, but if you're going to play varsity basketball, you got to be able to catch a hard pass. You can't lob the ball. If you do, the ball's going to get turned over. So you have to make sure that hard passes you have to be able to catch. Hard foul. That's a hard foul. He gets up, fired up. Two shots. Got her in the air. So it's a good fake. Not much you can do about that. Not sure about the rhythm on that free throw, though, to be honest. You missed that. Bad rhythm. Too many weird bounces and things. You got to be kind of a consistent rhythm so that maybe if you do it all the time. You got to be a little OCD when you shoot free throws. Timeout, Hollis Brookline. Seems to be a discussion about the timeout call. I think Coach thought maybe she was injured, but she's okay. She's shooting the free throw. She's just fine. She fell down. Oh, my goodness. She fell down. Yes, she's fine. You're not hurt every time you fall down. She's tough. Got back up. Ready to go. 47-46, Goffstown by one. Chance to tie it. Right here with 1:42 to go in the game. Got your own rebound back and got fouled again. White ball underneath on the foul. Oh, Goffstown now has 9 fouls. It's 9-6. Is that pump fake again? We're going to call that the AAU pump fake. Grab from behind. Didn't see a foul. Has 10 fouls. 1-1 next time. That's a two-shot foul. But now Hollis Brookline's in the bonus because Goffstown has 10 fouls. Hollis Brookline only has 6. They have 3 more to give until they get to the bonus. There's a free throw. Second free throw is good again. 48-47. Now we have a timeout with 1:26 to go, and we will be right back. 1:26 to go in the game. Goffstown has the ball out of bounds underneath, trailing 48-47 to Hollis Brookline, who's pressing full court man press, trying to throw Goffstown for a loop. Goffstown only has one player who can really bring the ball up the floor, and if she doesn't get it, they're in big trouble. So I think Mario called an offensive foul. There's that scoop shot. We're going to call that the scoop shot, 50-47. Little finger roll, a low finger roll. Scoop shot that she's gotten fouled on about 6 times. The one player you have to guard, don't stick your hand in there. Keep your hands up. So frustrating watching games now. Don't need to foul. Absolutely unnecessary. A rare miss from Walsh, 50-47. 1:09 to go in the game. 10 fouls. Hollis Brookline is into 1-1 here. I got a timeout on the Goffstown side while they trail 2 points by 2 points, and we'll be right back. Inbound the ball. You got to throw the ball where their hands are not. Not where their hands are, because most of the time it's going to get knocked down or stolen. The goal is to throw the ball away from where the defender's hands are. That's why either by the ear, which I think is my favorite pass, right by the ear, or a bounce pass below the arms. Especially when a big player's involved, you got to be able to get your arms down. And if you're of significant size, they can't get their hands down. 1-1, 49 seconds to go. It's now crucial that Hollis Brookline makes the free throws. And they missed the first one. They only lead by 2, but I saw that coming primary ball handler and get her the ball like they just did. And slips right underneath the arm and scores the basket, 52-48. 4-point lead, 32 seconds left in the game. 4-set. Greeny's clamoring, that's a foul. Little shaky there, Greeny. Little shaky. But she makes them both. 52-50, 23 seconds to go in the game. Got to start the clock. Here's where the clock is going to get interesting. Now, if they're smart, just hold the ball. Austin has to foul. The ball to your ball handler. Don't need to shoot. Fouls on Goffstown. So now we got another one-on-one situation with 5.9 seconds to go in the game. She makes these two, it's over. I'll close the door on that refrigerator early. Although with 5.9 seconds, it's not too early. There's the first one. This one, and the game is officially over. Because Hollis Brookline can stand right there at the free throw line and not move from where they are. And hopefully they will. Hollis Brookline is smart. They don't foul. They get back and they stand there. Or you foul and make them shoot free throws. She almost made a three, but it wouldn't have mattered anyway because they still would have lost the game 54-53. But in this case, they lost 54-50. Game over. Hollis Brookline wins that one in a tough battle and a comeback. And our next game will be up.